killer. Before the review starts for this video, I just want to say really quick in the beginning of the video that you may or may not see another video, possibly later today or tomorrow, depending what I do, if I'm not lazy or if I just, you know, don't find time to do stuff, you know, to record later today. And even if I do record later today, and depending on what time it is, I may upload it tomorrow. But I do want to say really quickly, because this video is going to go up around early-ish in the morning towards the afternoon, and you may or may not see another video maybe coming later on in the evening today or tomorrow morning. I just wanted to point that out really quick in the video. But anyways, we're back on Dragon Ball Super episode 108, titled Frieza and Frost Conjoined Malice, or however you want to, you know, translate it. But anyways, this episode was interesting. There was a lot of stuff that happened that was cool. There was a lot of stuff that kind of surprised me, because we finally get to see Frieza, you know, Emperor Frieza, the guy that I have been mentioning for the past couple of weeks, mentioning the fact that I find it hilarious that how he's a part of Universe 7, but yet he hasn't shown up for like an extended episode or whatever, or just an episode for him to shine on. And he finally shows up in episode 108. I was just waiting for whenever that was gonna fucking happen, and then there was obviously leaks that came out saying he's gonna come out in episode 108. And now he's finally in here. So the episode begins off with Rebrian and Goku fighting each other. Rebrian's trying to fight Goku with the power of love in Universe 2 and all that stupid bullshit. But we do get a lot of, you know, commentary from all the gods from different universes, saying that they're really impressed with how strong these warriors are fighting in the tournament. And then we go back to a shot of Gohan. This may or may not be a short video. It may depend on how much I, you know, talk, obviously. But we get back to Gohan, actually. Gohan is in this episode. He's fighting a Universe 4 guy. Gohan's getting pushed back. He's hiding. Gets attacked by Universe 2 Yardra. I forgot his name, I apologize. But he gets attacked by the Universe 4... Not Universe 4, Universe 2 Yardra. And of course, because he is a Yardrat, he knows the instantaneous movement technique, or instant transmission to dub. So obviously Gohan is struggling a little bit. He's getting pushed back by this Yardrat from Universe 2. And, you know, he's kind of holding back. You can kind of tell that Gohan is really holding back the power that obviously he has. And then Frieza decides to show up before the Yardrat is about to fire a blast at Gohan. Frieza shows up, and he kind of stops it all. And this is really where the episode kind of takes a turn with Frieza, because, you know, they don't really know if they can trust Frieza, because Frieza, well, is a bad dude, you know. He can't really be trusted that much, and the fact that he's a part of Universe 7's team, you know, we kind of speculate what he could and could not be doing within the episode. In the episode, they actually are talking about what Frieza may actually be potentially planning to do, which is, you know, betray Universe 7, be the last one to survive, get the Super Dragon Balls, and potentially kill a god. Whis states that the Dragon Balls may potentially have the ability to kill a god. Now, how powerful of a god? Maybe like the angels and the gods' instructions and the Kaioshins? Probably, most likely, Super Dragon Balls can do that. The Grand Priest, maybe? But I'm gonna go ahead and say that it probably can't kill someone like Zeno. I don't think it can kill someone like Zeno. But who knows? The Super Dragon Balls have the capability to be able to do a lot of, you know, massive things that Namekian Dragon Balls can't do, and especially Earth Dragon Balls. So Frieza stops the fight, but he decides to go in the sidelines and basically just watch Gohan and the Yardrat. I apologize for not knowing his name, but he starts watching the two of them fight. Gohan's clearly not fighting at full power. He stops the fight again, and then he very clearly states that, you know, Gohan would have won if he didn't just toy around and use his full power. And then Frieza is just wailing on this guy. He actually does the classic move with his tail where he grabs him around the neck and then starts punching him in his gut and his rib cage, like how he did with Vegeta back in the Namek Saga, which I enjoyed. It was very interesting. He then shoots a blast at the guy, and, you know, because this is Frieza, they all think that he probably killed him. Even, you know, the gods from their own respective, his own respective universe think that he killed him and think that he should be disqualified. But Frieza's like, no, I didn't kill him. I knew not to kill him because I didn't want to be disqualified. And
yeah.
But anyways, Frost shows up. Gohan's there kind of like weak and shit because, you know, kind of got wailed on. Frost shows up, and then the cat came out of the bag, as Frieza said himself. It was revealed that Frieza and Frost had decided to team up with each other and, you know, just kill off, or not kill off, but knock off everybody else off of the arena in order to be the last two to survive and basically, you know, kind of win the tournament of power. Things turn out differently, as I'll get onto later in the video, but Frieza, you know, basically reveals that he's teaming up with Frost, but of course, Frost is really skeptical of Frieza, not knowing if he can fully trust him or not. So Frost is telling Frieza to go ahead and fight Gohan, and then Frieza starts, you know, wailing on Gohan. He starts attacking him, and Zeno points out, like, oh, they're fighting each other in their own respective universes. So, you know, Frieza's, you know, wailing on Gohan. He's, you know, proving that even in just his final form, his final base form is, you know, superior to Gohan. Gohan goes ultimate, Frieza goes golden, and then the episode proceeds on to see that Frieza is very obviously probably going to betray his universe, you know, knock off Gohan off the arena. And then, you know, Frost is very impressed. He's never seen Golden Frieza or the Golden Transformation in general, so he's very impressed with Frieza and how strong he is in this transformation. And so Frieza was surely that you can become strong. Frieza was saying to Frost that he could become stronger. That's what I meant to say. I apologize. But Frieza's telling Frost he could become stronger. Maybe not to this extent, but probably to this. And then, you know, Frieza decides to go into his buff 100% full power form. And then Frost is like, oh yeah, I can do that too. And then we get kind of the big surprise that I probably should have expected, really, but didn't for whatever reason. And Frieza knocks Frost off the arena. Before he does, he says, would you like to learn one more thing? And whatever. And then he says, don't trust anybody to Frost. And then Frost, you know, getting caught off guard by Frieza. Frieza knocks him off of the arena. And then Frost is pissed. He's on the sidelines. He's shouting at Frieza, about to shoot off a blast towards Frieza, but Zeno then erases him. He doesn't erase the universe of Universe 6, but he erases Frost, telling him, no, you can't do that. If you do it again, I'll erase the universe. And then Champa is, you know, just being Champa. But then Gohan actually gets up, and then he starts playing along, or he was playing along with Frieza, knowing that he may have had a plan because Frieza wasn't, you know, going that completely serious. And, you know, the episode kind of ends off with Frieza just walking away, you know, kind of just not knowing what the hell he's going to do next. So the episode ends with a shot of Ribrian and Goku fighting again, and that's the end of the episode. Next week, we're not going to get an episode of Dragon Ball Super, unfortunately, which is kind of going to suck, but of course, you know, Toei is going to air the special for One Piece next week. It's going to be a one-hour special of One Piece. So for those of you who watch One Piece, go enjoy that, of course. I don't watch One Piece personally myself, but, you know, for those of you who do watch it, go ahead and enjoy that next week. And in the week after that, we're going to get our special, our one-hour special for Dragon Ball Super, where we're potentially going to see Goku fighting Jiren, Goku using the Spirit Bomb, and a whole bunch of other crazy shit's going to happen. So, anyways, that's the end of the video. And also, one other thing I want to point out. Episode in terms of animation and quality, it was pretty good, honestly. It was really good. Animation, you know, was stable most of the time. It was actually really damn good. And Sumitomo music for the whole entirety of this arc in general, and especially in this episode, was very, very good, and I was very impressed with what they actually did in the episode. and I can only hope to see more great things coming from Super, and hopefully maybe not as much shitty things from Boruto. Actually, that's the video that I mentioned earlier in the beginning of the video, and it's gonna be revolving around Boruto. It's not an episode review, obviously, because the next episode hasn't come out yet. But it's kind of gonna be something that I wanted to talk about for a little bit after Swaikage uploaded a video about Boruto and stuff like that, and it kind of inspired me to possibly make a video on it. So, anyways, like I said, it's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like. If you're new to the channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button for future content just like this. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.